Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Kindly subscribe and click the notification button so that you can be notified when I upload a new video. I'm Thaddeus Baluka, your chemistry mentor. And today I'm going to deal with the organic analysis. This is a follow-up lesson from the question that I had posted on Thursday. So today we are going to look at how to answer these particular questions. We're going to have a look at how to answer this particular question for organic analysis. And I said, before you look at the questions, before you look at my analysis, those are good. You go to previous video, you watch and you try to answer the questions before you come here to get the question. So we want to see how do you answer these questions. You're looking at the study the flowchart diagram below and answer the question that follow from where. There is a question of identifying substance A, B, C, D, all the way out to T, and you require to get 13 marks there. Name the reagent and condition used in the following steps. So you're supposed to name the reagents, the conditions that are used there, and there you need like 15 marks. You're supposed to draw the structure of the compound B, M, and N, 3 marks. And then you write equation for reaction 1, reaction 6, process 3, and reaction 8, 4 marks. When you add all the marks there, that is 7 plus 15, that becomes 22 plus 13, that is 35 marks. So from there now, we know all the letters that are given there, you need to know the names of those kind of reactions that are there. So we are starting from here. When you're given a question like that, before you start answering the question, first of all, analyze the flowchart. So like this is, we're having hexane here. Hexane is undergoing process 1 to form butane and another substance A. So this is an alkane. So this process must have been cracking. This should be cracking. This should be cracking. So therefore being the case, we can try to look at the product. Like this product here, this should be, this is butane. Butane is C4H10. So the butane being C4H10, so we want to get the other product. So the carbon there are 6, the carbon there are 6. Now here there are 4, so 2 are remaining. Then we have the hydrogens. How many hydrogen will remain from there? So we're having 10 hydrogen there, but there are 14. So 4 are remaining. So this substance A might be ethane. So ethane is undergoing reaction 2 in presence of excess air to get C and D. This must be combustion. So being combustion, substance C and D should be carbon 4 oxide plus water. So that is carbon 4 oxide and water. So we are reacting ethene in with hydrogen. So this is now, this should be, let me try to wrap there. This should be, hydrogenation, and this substance here B should be ethane. So, and you need to know when hydrogenation is taking place, what are the conditions? You require nickel or palladium catalyst and a temperature of 150 to 250 degrees Celsius. We have reaction 4 whereby you're converting ethane to alcohol E. This alcohol must be ethanol, that is C2H5OH. That must be ethanol. So that is how you have analyzed that particular end. Then you can come here. We're having calcium carbide plus F. According to organic chemistry, when during organic chemistry, calcium carbide reacts with water to form ethane. So this F should be water. This F should be water. Water and calcium carbide react to form E gas G, and this should be ethane. This should be ethane, you write that. Ethane is now undergoing reaction 7 to form ethane. So here, the reagent should be hydrogen gas, and this is hydrogenation, so to form ethane. So ethane is being converted to chloroethane. So the reagent we are using here should be HCl. Very important, that is to be hydrogen chloride gas. Many mistakes, students, whatever they see chlorine here, they just go for the reagent is chlorine. That is a common mistake. So this is an addition reaction, not hydrohalogenation. Reaction of alkenes and alkynes with halogen, that is chlorine, bromine, fluorine, and hydrogen halides, like hydrogen bromide, hydrogen chloride, that is simply an addition reaction. Then we have alcohol being converted to this. This is the same as reaction number 4. So this is simply hydration or hydrolysis. Either hydration or hydrolysis can be okay, can convert. This one is not hydrolysis. This is dehydration. Process 3 is the reverse of reaction 4. So this one is dehydration. So this alcohol must have been propanol. This must be ethanol. C2H5, then OH. So this is ethanol being converted to ethane. This is dehydration, removal of water. And dehydration is removal of chemically combined water. Then we're having ethane reacting with HBr to form this. So this just like this one, and here you're going to get bromoethane. This is simply bromoethane. So, and here we are having ethane undergoing polymerization, that is processed to form polymer P, and this should be polyethane. Very important. Then the other one that is remaining here, we are having reagent T react with soda lime to form butane. This is decarboxylation reaction. This is decarboxylation. Many students don't. This one is not in many of the books. This is decarboxylation. Decarboxylation. Let me just wrap this. This is decarboxylation reaction. This reaction here is called decarboxylation. It is called decarboxylation, whereby we are converting a sodium alkanoid in presence of soda lime to form the corresponding alkane. So this is the decarboxylation reaction. And remember, when you're forming alkane, you react an alkane to get the corresponding, you react sodium alkanoate with soda lime to get the corresponding alkane less one carbon atom. So if here we want to prepare butane, this should be sodium pentanoate. This should be sodium pentanoate to give us butane. If you want to get methane, you use sodium ethanoate. If you want to get ethane, you use sodium propanoate. So we are burning butane in limited supply of air, and here we are going to get carbon 2 oxide plus water. So K and L is carbon 2 oxide and water. So that's it. So that is the K and L, period. We have now analyzed the question. So from there, it will be very easy for us now to look at to answer the questions. Once that's how you first of all analyze it, you try to connect, you try to synthesize and comprehend the flowchart, then you go for the questions. And when you go for the question, like naming the product, naming the substance A, B, C, D, E, F, up to T, already we have already named them here. So we just go to the answers. So we're going to find A is ethane, B is ethane, C and D are carbon dioxide and water, N will score. That is now, this is the D. We are looking at C and D. So D, C and D interchangeably can be used any can be the same. So this can be used for, we can use this one here. because it is C and D, or the water can be here, or it can also be in this side. So we're talking about C and D here. C and D, so any can be used, carbon dioxide and water. C can be named as carbon dioxide or water. D can be named as carbon dioxide and water. So this is what we are talking about. So the answers should be like that. E is alcohol E, the one that is we are converting it into ethanol, that we are here now. So alcohol E, this is must be ethanol. Then we have water F. Water, that F is water. And remember, you're taught to identify. So when you're taught to identify, we can pick the question, the name, or the formula. So for F, this whereby we're having calcium carbide plus F, that should be either water, you can write the formula or the name. Gas G is when you're reacting calcium carbide and water, you get ethane. Then carbon dioxide, this one where you are reacting now butane in limited supply of air. And when you are burning butane in limited supply of air, that is whereby now we are getting carbon dioxide and water. Any can work, can be used interchangeably. Even whatever you have placed, the K, the L can be named as carbon dioxide, and also this one can also be named as this. So it can be used interchangeably. Alcohol M is the one that we are converting alcohol M to ethene, that is ethanol. And then N is whereby we are now reacting ethene with HBr, so you get bromoethane. Then we have polymer P, and when ethene is converted to polymer P, that is polyethane. And the T is thereby we are having substance T that reacts with soda lime to form butane. You use sodium butanoate. So each one is a mark. Each one is a mark. Like that, like that, like that, like that, like that, like that, like that. So that's 13 marks for all those answers that are given there. Just remember that L and M can be, L can be carbon 2, K can be water because it is named anyway. So we can be able to mark any of that. So the other one is to reagents used in the following steps. So we're having step 3, whereby now we are converting alcohol M to ethene. That is dehydration. Dehydration will require a temperature of 160 to 180. Remember, in exam, you give a specific temperature that is within there. You can give a temperature of 170, you can give a temperature of 165, you can give a temperature of 180, so you can give any. You can give a temperature of 160, 170, 180. Just give a specific temperature, but the temperature should be within that range. So the reagent is concentrated sulfuric acid. Reaction 5 is whereby now we are reacting ethene with HCl. The reaction is addition, not hydrohalogenation. It is addition reaction. And I've said reaction of alkenes and alkynes with halogens and hydrogen halide is simply called addition. So this reaction takes place in room temperature. The reagent is hydrogen chloride. So the other one we require there is the reaction 4. Reaction 4 is whereby we are now converting ethene to ethanol. So you require a pressure of, that is hydration, 60 atmospheres, temperature of 300 degrees Celsius, and phosphoric 5-acid catalyst. The reagent is steam. Polymerization, whereby you're converting ethene to polymer P, which is polyethane. So you require high temperature and high pressure. That's the only reaction whereby you require high pressure and high temperature. So, and the reagent will require simply ethane. So we simply require ethane molecule, that's it. Then we have our reaction number 3, we can call it hydrogenation or even addition, and you require a temperature of between 150 to 250. You can pick any of that. And nickel or palladium catalyst, a pressure of 200 to 250. So for here, you pick mostly the temperature and then the catalyst. The temperature, you can pick any temperature. You can give a temperature of 160, temperature of 180, temperature of 200, any of that, as long as the temperature is between 150 to 250, but must be a specific temperature. The reagent is hydrogen. Very important for reaction number 3, whereby we are now converting ethane to ethane. C, we are supposed to name B. B was ethane. You are told to draw the structural formula of B, which is ethane now. So you, it must be open structure, not CH3, it's wrong. So it must be completely open. M was whereby you're having alcohol, which is being converted to ethane, and this is ethanol. So the correct, this is when you write for us, when you're told to draw the structural formula, it must be the open structure. It must be the open what? The open structure of ethanol. So like this. Then we have bromoethane. Again, very open structure. So this, don't give this. This is wrong, and this is wrong. But now, but this is now the correct version. This is the correct version. One mark like that. Then you get the final answer. Then you're told to write equation for the following reactions. The reaction one was burning butane in limited supply of air, and you get carbon, 2 oxide and water. For organic chemistry, the state symbols are not important. Reaction 6, whereby we're having ethane reacting with HCl, and the product is chloroethane. Again, the state symbols are not important, but it must be balanced. Then here we have ethanol being converted to ethane. That is process number 3 to get that. That is dehydration. And then finally, we have reaction 8, whereby we have calcium carbide reacting with F, which is water, to form ethane plus calcium hydroxide. That is how you are able to get the marking point for that. Just remember, common mistake is the common mistake that I have lighted here is like, in many times, when we tell students ethane reacts with HCl, they tell us this is hydrohalogenation. When reacting with chlorine, others will say this is chlorination. It should not, that is not correct. Talk about reaction of alkenes and alkynes with hydrogen and hydrogen halide is simply called addition reaction. Very important. So make sure that we're able to get that. For reaction with the only one that we normally give the name is reaction with hydrogen, we can call it hydrogenation. But remember, hydrogenation is still a part of addition. It's only that now, in many times, the examiner will ask this one in terms of process. This will be mostly asked because of a process, because it's an industrial process. It is used industrially in manufacture of margarine. So we are likely going to ask you that. Remember, if you are talking about, if there was also a reaction between this one and chlorine, butane and chlorine, this kind of a reaction will be called what? This is a substitution reaction and requires UV light. So make sure that you are able to have a look at that. In our next, this one, this question was normally analyzing more of organic chemistry one. In our next lesson, I'll be able to take you through a flowchart involving organic chemistry 2 and 1 combined. Remember, you can be able to convert from alkanes, from a preparation of ethane to ethane, to ethene to ethane, even to alcohol and alkanoic acid. Very important for you to capture that. So see you next time in the comment section. Please remember to subscribe and click the notification button. And also, let me also see from the comments the area that you want clarified. Also, let me see your score out of 35. How many are able to get that? Thank you. See you next time. Bye.